Hi, this is ICSE Malek and welcome back to the English classes. Now, today I was wondering about certain things when I saw lights, when I talked to phone, how all these things have been invented. I was wondering, many other things raised question that how these things are being made and who has made these things. And what sort of mind this person would be having that he has invented, he has thought this much far and this much wonderful things. So I thought about Thomas Alva Edison, who has invented this electricity, this light, Graham Bell, who has invented telephone, and many other scientists who have invented all these things. So during this time also, I came across one wonderful topic of 5th grade and the name is Ashraf's Invention. Yes, of course, today we are going to learn about Ashraf's Invention. By reading the title itself, we can come to know that Ashraf's Invention means Ashraf would be there and he might be doing certain inventions. But this topic is far different than we thought, than we think. Okay, so first of all, there are many characters, and the main character is Ashraf. Before that, many other things I would like to talk about Ashraf, that he's just a student, a kid who's studying in school, and along with his friends Eugene and Segun, the whole story revolves around these three characters. So if we begin the story, there was a normal day, everything began normally, but one thing which was abnormal, and that was Ashraf. And it seemed that Ashraf now was in hurry. Everything for breakfast, he took back fast and he just went to the bus hurriedly. But just everything else was slowly, happening slowly. Ashraf was quick, Ashraf was in hurry. It seemed that he might be waiting for something, that he wants to share, he wants to do something. So in a hurry, he did all these things. But when he went into the school bus, he found that Ada, the school bus driver, she has just decided that she will take her time, she will take the bus very slowly. As soon as Ashraf saw the glimpses, just a glimpses of the school, he just ran from the running bus. So others shouted that, let the bus stop first. So he said, I'm in hurry, I need to go. So he just reached to the class, and the first period was of science. In science period, everybody was paying attention in the class, but Ashraf was looking at the clock. Now you might be thinking, what's the surprise, what's the suspense, why he's doing so, why he's behaving like that. So as soon as the first period got ended, and he was waiting for the first break, so at 11 o'clock, so as soon as the bell rang, he just ran to the yard, and in that yard he met his friend Eugene. He talked that, I have a plane, and wherever we want to go, we can go. So he called Segun, that Segun, come here. Ashraf has a plane, and wherever you want to go, we want to go, we can go. Even Jupiter, Saturn, wherever we can go. So Segun came towards them and remembered, make them reminded about many other things that passed. Ashraf is a child who liked to do inventions, and who like to find out certain new things. So earlier also he made many things, for example one time capsule. So Segun was waiting for the time that by eating the time capsule, when we wake up, we can ahead 2 grade up. So Segun said that, I stopped reading, even I did not read. So even I did not read, and I got all D grades. This was the experience of Eugene. Now Segun said that, and I also remembered, once you made a radio transmission, means that by that the things or the electricity, the transmission, the radius which comes from the radio and which makes you invisible, and I made many faces and I got punished also. I had to face many problems after that. So is it like that? So they said that you will never give up, right? Your inventions are more likely troubles, you know, they are not which we can find more interesting, or they are just keep us in trouble. So Ashraf said that no, this time it is very different, and this time I assure you that definitely I have a plan and it is very good. We can go wherever we want to go. So both Eugene and Segun said that if you are ready to give us chocolate cake, your mother's chocolate cake, so we are ready to come. So they were tempted just by the chocolate cake. They did not very excited. They were not very excited to see the plane, but they just tempted by the chocolate cake. So both were ready. Now all these three friends started moving towards the ground to talk with the other friends. And suddenly Simon talked that this time I wonder what are you trying to make? Means what different thing are you trying to do? So Ashraf said that don't just ignore him. Don't share anything with him. But suddenly one of his friends said that Ashraf has a plan. So wherever you want to go, you can book a ticket and you can go wherever you want to go. So everybody started laughing and Ashraf got angry with both of his friends. So Ashraf was very angry that I told you not to share with him, then why did you share? So both his friends said that okay, we were just kidding, and you know, most of your experiments have failed, so we were just trying to say that don't do such kind of experiments which make us into trouble. So Ashraf just, you know, dramatically he just showed that he's angry and he's very 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 depressed now. So both his friends said that okay, we are ready to come, okay, we will come to your house. So now as soon as the school got over, Ashraf ran to his house. He just wanted to make arrangements for his friends also. So he took some cushions, tied them tightly so that his friends can get a comfortable seat. And along with that, he need to arrange everything for the safety also, cockpit, steering, wheels. Just when he made arrangements, he just admired it. So it was a very magnificent with strong wheels, you know. So what happened that he had to take arrangements of the chocolate cakes also. So he was looking for something. So he took two hats, round hats, in that he could keep both the chocolate cakes and everything. So he took the round hats and his yellow bicycle helmet he took, and wearing, he just sat in the cockpit and was waiting for his friend. He was very eager, you know, he was wondering that where these friends have been now. So he just suddenly heard a voice that his friend declared that, oh, we have come over here and I have missed a football match with my father. So please make sure that whatever you have made, it is very 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 interesting and wonderful. So Ashraf from backside, he shouted that, come at the backside, I'm here in my plane. So both of his friends came, and suddenly other children were also came, and the children, when they look, so it was a tree and he tied some cushions, and just there was an imaginary cockpit. So everybody started laughing. So and from these children, Eugene and Segun, they both came forward, and just when they saw the plane, oh, it is not a plane, it's just a tree. So Ashraf was depressed again. He became sad, just acting dramatically he was sad. Okay, so both the friends, Eugene and Segun, they went on the tree and encourage him that one day, we believe that all these things which you are making imaginary, you will make it real. We believe that, but we will also support you for making all these things, you know. So first of all, his friend said that we need to start from the small things, you know, like how to boil an egg using sunlight and many other things, and we will also help you to do all these things. And along with that, both the friends said that you can make all these things very easily because you have curiosity. You have many other qualities to know the things and to make other things. So one day definitely you will be successful in this. But hold on steadily and sit properly, otherwise we will fall off the tree, and you need to invent an instant parachute for all of us. So this way all these friends again sat, enjoyed the chocolate cake on the tree, and they enjoyed it. So by these lesson we can come to know that Ashraf is a boy who had a curiosity. He wanted to do many other things and he was making imaginary. You know children, curiosity is a thing which can lead to the new invention. If we talk about Newton, how he had invented gravity, this way only, that why that apple has fallen down only, why it did not go upside. So this question, this curiosity led to the invention of gravity. If we talk about Thomas Alva Edison, many other invention, he also did not go to school. He just read everything at house, did experiments, and then he became a wonderful, awesome scientist just by reading the things. But he had a curiosity. Einstein, many other scientists, if we talk, like Wright brothers, that when they were talking about that we will make people fly in the sky, and everybody was laughing, but they made it successful and proved that whatever we think, we can do it. We just need to be determined that I will do it, and you just need to do it properly, with a proper system, with a proper technique, with proper knowledge. Knowledge, you know, it is very essential. If you have knowledge, if you have curiosity to get knowledge, then you can learn whatever you want to learn. That is a no boundary, no limit is there. Okay, so dear children, you also just increase your curiosity. You know, two questions are there: how and why. How this happened, why this happened. These two questions, if you will ask now, you will increase your curiosity. And you must have these two questions, that whatever things are happening, how it has happened and why it has happened. And if you will search, if you will research it by yourself, then definitely you can come to know, you can know about the basic, you can know about why it has happened, how it has happened. Okay, so whatever things come across to you, just ask why and how it has happened, and one day you can also be a very successful, because the world, you know, it is full of secrets. Many other nature's secrets we still don't know. So I hope one day many of you will be a great scientist, will be great people of great fields or different fields. Okay, so dear children, and nowadays you have enough time to explore all these things, to explore the world by exploring the book, by exploring the internet, by using internet. You know, we are very resourceful. We have all the resources which we want to find out any kind of information we can get. So all the very best. Take care. Stay home. Stay safe. All the best. Thank you.